Hey, what's up, guys? Today's video, we will do a best of 5 pro versus pro against one of the best players in Clash Royale history, Igor. He did so well in the Brain Shawn Cup, last season number 6, on this account he has number 2 finish as the best season. He has, I think, 5 number 1 finishes. He's just incredibly good. He is so good with Morten, like a cheap side against Jennery. He's one of the best players overall in Clash Royale. Let me know in the comment section which pro you guys want to see next. I might ask B-Red in the future. If he says no, it's fine. If he says yes, even better. But let me know which pro you guys want to see next and let me know who is gonna win that. What do you guys think? Who's gonna win, me or Igor? Don't forget to use creator code Morten in the shop as well. Really helps me out, really supports me. And don't forget to follow Igor on his Twitch, YouTube, Twitter, everywhere. He's like doing great content. He's like streaming a lot recently, so make sure to follow him. And yeah, subscribe to the channel, close to 70,000 subscribers. I appreciate any one of you doing that. And I would say, let's jump to the games. Let's go, guys. So guys, you're in the first game against Igor. Good luck. Honestly, one of my favorite players. Like, if I'm watching gameplay, I want to watch Igor or Mubi right now. So we go with bats in the back. Decide to play a Mega Knight deck. A Mega Knight deck with the Mine in it. Because Igor is, he's going with Morten. He's going with Comfort. I expect it. Like, man, in Brain Shawn Cup, it's insane. He used so much Morten. You're thinking like, that's dumb, right? He's so dang good with it. He's using so much Morten. Like, that was a great try by him. And he's so good with Morta. He's just insanely good with Morta, but like, people weren't able to counter him. He won like every matchup with it. It's just insane. And yeah, I'm trying to improve on my Morta game as well, because especially with the Q unit, it feels like Morta is one of the better decks in the game. So we go with Minor Bats. Let's see, what is he gonna do against that? He's gonna drop his Skullman. So it looks like it might be Morta bait, classic, old school. This is what you guys want to see, right? That's why we got Ego on. So we're going in with that, and we're going in just with a Hunter. Okay, we're going in with we're going for Mega Knight here. Because the cannon card is out of cycle. Using Spear Goblins. I mean, he's kinda low on Elixir right now, so a lock wouldn't help. He's really low on Elixir right now. He didn't think that we have Mega Knight in our deck, right? He didn't expect us to have Mega Knight. So we're getting a good amount of damage here. Fimi just going in for minor bats. Keep up the pressure for sure. Miners here, miner always at the spot. I really like it because some players are playing the Spear Gobs in the spot, and then the miner, the Spear Gobs are attacking the miner, and the bats are getting a ton of damage. So I think we're just going to drop an Ice Bird here. And yeah, I kind of expect him to go in with Morta in the first game because he's like playing a lot of Morta recently, and he doesn't care about opponents. So I decided it's not a bad deck choice to go in with this deck. So I think we're going with that. Going with bats. Going with an Ice Bird. Oh, that's juicy. So we go for Miner. Let's see. What is he going to drop here? We go for Earthquake for sure. I think he has like no answer to deal with the bats. The Miner, if the Miner would have survived, it would have been so dang good. But still, we are fine. I think we go for Hunter in the back. And we go for Mega Knight here. That was a kind of like obvious play he did here, but he had to do it. So we're going in with a Mega Knight in front of that. Going with bats. Going with Miner. And we go with an Earthquake over here. Going with Spear Goblins as well. Going in with an Ice Bird as well. He's dropping a good Cannon card. Cannon card gets a ton of value, but the Hunter as well. Hunter is doing an insane amount of work here. So we go with bats. We go for Miner. And we go in with an Earthquake here. I hope the Miner's able to get it up. Not yet, man. It's so close. Even I got a Mega Knight connection. Because, like, I don't know. It's like, sometimes you think, like, why is this game so close? Even he didn't get any damage, it feels like. So we go in with a Miner. We go with an Earthquake and getting a good game. Can we get a good game here? Can we get it? Not getting a Draglich here. GZ is well played. Easy matchup. Good deck decision by us, but it was still so close because he's just the best Morta player in Clash Royale. So guys, next game, and yes, I know you guys want to see me using Morta against the Morta God, right? We're doing it. We are doing it using Morta against the best Morta player in Clash Royale. So he's jumping a fisherman, so he's deciding to go out of his comfort zone, I would say. And looks like it's going to be Royal Giant. So we're going to use a Hunter here. He's just gonna drop this recruit. I hate them. So we go for Morta here. Igor, why are you playing this deck? I thought you were playing high skill cap decks. Just joking, man. That's for sure fine. He can play whatever he wants to. Besides Igor and Rage. So... I mean, I'm going with an Ice Bird, going in with this, and now we're just going to drop a Hunter here. Good defense. What do you even say? Perfect defense. So we go for Miner in the back. You don't really want to play the Miner in this spot against Fisher, because if he's going for... with a Fisherman like here, he can activate the Miner, the King Tower with the Fisherman against the Miner. So not play your Miner in the normal spot behind the tower, because opponent can activate King Tower. So we go for Mortar, I would say, here. He's going to drop Archer, so we go for an Ice Bird. And with this Ice Bird, we should get one hit. No, we don't, so we need to go Spear Gob still. Or we can go Spear Gob because Snowball's out of sight, and he's just going to use his Lumberjack. So I'm going to use a Knight here. Not an easy matchup at all, but we could take the dub here. So we go for Miner in the inside spot in case he wants to go for Fisherman. We let the Miner at the Knight tank for sure. So that's a great Miner placement. That's a really great Miner placement. And I think I'm just gonna go in with a high Mortar. And Spear Goblins as well. And I think I'm just gonna Earthquake his Recutes here because they're kinda annoying, and with the Mortar splashing them away should be an easy defense. So I think I'm gonna go in for Royal Delivery. Go for Hunter High. I just wanna make sure he's not able to balloon this side. And he could go in on this side. Yes, he does. So we need to go for another Hunter. I think with a Miner in front of that, we should get a ton of damage. Okay. I mean, we need to go in with that, we need to go with an Ice Bird, and we need to go in with... Okay, we know we have a might have a big problem. So we go for Hunter. Delivery. I mean, we might have a bit overextended there, so I really want to go opposite lane now. So, you're getting a ton of chip damage because he's low on Elixir and he doesn't have Snowball in hand, so we're kind of coming back here. Going for Mortar low. Perfect Mortar placement against that. At least that's what I'm seeing Igor always doing, so I think it has to be the best placement. So we go for an Earthquake. Earthquake is killing the shields from the Royal Recutes. And we go over for Miner in the back. Delivery. I think we're just gonna Earthquake that. Okay. So we're going with that, we're going with this. Okay, it might be a ton of damage from that Fire Dragon, but I don't think it's, yeah, almost got an X lock, so we go from EQ and we're just gonna play another Mortar. Let's see, he's gonna do that. So I think I'm just gonna go with this, going with that. Okay, Mortar high. Going in with a Miner in the back. Earthquake on his archers. And as long as we are like keeping up the good defense, 30 more seconds. It should be a dub. Go for Mortar High, go for an Ice Bird as well. GG's well played. Let's go, another victory. I think we played overall really, really well. He's gonna give us a well played. Let's go. Man, that means so much to me. Like, I'm not the best Mortar player in the world. I'm trying to improve on this Mortar Miner control deck because I think it has, like, really, like, most matchups are really good with the deck. So we're getting a 2-0 for us. I'm gonna see you next game. And I think, like, you see me, the improvements from Pro v Pro. So in the first Pro v Pro, I wasn't really in form, so right now I'm practicing a lot. I'm practicing daily 6-7 hours for CL, so you guys see that I hope you guys see that I'm playing better than the last Pro v Pros, and I just want to improve daily. Because CL's guy is starting soon. I'm really grinding up right now with different pro players, practicing a full night until 6 AM to get ready for CL. So, guys, another game here against Igor once again. Man, that's weird. We play against Igor 3 times in a row. So we go with Bats in the back, and he's going back to Mortar. So we're dropping a Magic Archer here. He's just gonna drop that. So we need to go for an Earthquake. I hope the Mortar's not gonna get... What? That's the Igor bonus, come on! No comment, guys. So, okay. He has Fireball, so he's not playing the Earthquake variation. He's dropping this, so we wanna go on. He's always playing like his Mine in the back in the first spot because he knows I might have Delivery, so I don't get any Delivery value, which is like a small thing. But I think we go with Voilogs here. Just gonna split them. It looks like he is having... playing Mortar Bait once again. Most likely his favorite Mortar Bait deck right now. Considering he's playing it a lot. Skeletons, because then otherwise the Mortar would connect to top, because after a building dies or like a spawner dies, the Mortar is always retargeting, like the same with Expo, and then the tower would have gotten attacked. So I was sure to go with Skeletons on his cannon card, because then the Mortar would have attacked that. And so I think I'm going with Voidhawks here in the front of that. I'm just gonna play it a bit far away that he's not gonna get as much fireball as he wants. So he's gonna fireball that. It's fine. And like, I'm like a guy who's always fine if the opponent goes in with the fireball and the Voidhawks, because they still get 400, 500, 300 damage. At the same time, right now he had to use a ton of elixir. Now I get them a free magic archer, and I prefer to have a magic archer in the field. I just like that. I think it's just a good move for me if opponent's doing that. So we go for a magic archer like that. He could log it. He's just going for cannon card. Let's see. And we're going for King Tower activation. We go with Bats. And I think we go for Royal Hooks here. We go for Hunter in the back. He's gonna fireball that. Ta-da. Go for an Earthquake. We're just going for an Earthquake cycle here because we might get a one hit. No, we don't. Okay, King Tier activation is on. So I think we go for Cage. Goof bats like that. Hunter. Skeletons. Hunter. Magic Archer. Go for Voidhawks High. And we go in with an Earthquake here. To get some chip in. At the same time, it's fine. So we go for the Cage. No, the Kanaka is connecting. Why? I thought it's no. Okay. Okay, we're still in that. But yes, it's getting spicy. So we go for the Earthquake here because he has to use Goblin as Spear Goblins. Or like his Goblin Gang, and we get a ton of damage here. He's most likely just gonna go with Minor Fireball. Knew that. Got him. So I think we go for Voidhawks over here. Go with Bats to the side. And we go with an Earthquake. And the Cannon Cut die. Okay. Log is enough with that. So we go off with Magic Archer. GG's. He played so well. Honestly, the cannon card was annoying. The one cannon card connection, like the cannon card gets so much value, and I messed up once. The King Tokyoation was great, but still he played really well, and we're just going to jump into the next one. So guys, we decided to go in with Hawk EQ, because I think it should be a good matchup against all of the Mortar decks from him. And he decides to play something else. Ah, we got juked. Okay, but still think we can win. So we're seeing the Ice Wizard coming down, so we're just going to snowball that. What is he playing? Going Skeletons in front of that. So we go for Log. He might play like Royal Giant EQ. He's playing Spell Cycle. Oh no, dude. Come on, dude. He's going on Spell Cycle here. Earthquake. Does he have enough elixir for Tornado? I think so. Yes, he does. Okay. Ice with Nado, Bomb Tower, Tesla. That's tough. That's really, really tough. Oh no, I think Okay. Don't really wanna get reverse sweeped here. That's not what I'm looking for. So I think, man, he needs to play perfect, but he can, he's ego, he's so good with this cheap cycle decks, with this mechanics. So, going for Arches in the back. And now I think I'm just gonna go in with a knight in front of that. I'm gonna use a lock here. Using a log. Come on, Hawk! Using knight. Archers. Good archers. Using an earthquake here. Oh, the snowball is coming down! The snowball is coming down! Oh, so close. But still, we got a good amount of damage. Earthquake, snowball, earthquake, no, so close. So close. I think I played it so well. I think we played it so well. Okay, 2-2. This is gonna be all or nothing. So, 2-2. All or nothing against Igor. So, we go for Mortar once again. And it could be a Mortar Mirror matchup. For everything. Yeah. Going in with a hunter, with a knight. He has Royal Hawks. I think I still need to use a lock here. Okay, Royal Hawks Mortar. Not looking like an easy matchup. Okay, we both have Mortar. Which has Knight against our Miner? So we're doing this. Using a log. Ah, that's a tough matchup. If I at least would have had delivery, but we don't. So, how are we gonna break through his knight defense against our miner, and how are we gonna defend? So I think we need to go for Hunter High. And I think we go for Ice Bird and the miner. So at least the miner's chipping away a bit, but he can just use his boys in front. Use a lock here. A mortar and a miner in the back. Using earthquake. No hits! Okay. Problem is, I can't really switch lanes anymore. So, going in for a knight in front of that. Fire's chipping awake quite a lot, actually. That's it. GG's, he played so well. Honestly, that was a... Sorry guys, I apologize for the guard. I think it was a tough matchup. We can go over the matchups a bit. I think it was a really... I would say it was my matchup, but it's not an easy matchup at all because it's kind of tough for me to defend Balloon or like the double lane pressure if he's going to go Inferno Dragon at one side. Delivery helps a lot, but I don't think it's an easy matchup at all, but I still would say if I played perfect, it's my matchup. I think it's most likely... I would even say it's his matchup. I could have played it slightly better, but I think I don't really have anything against this miner, right? I have bats, yes, but... Overall, like, he's really good with Mortar. Cannon card is so annoying. I don't really think it's an easy matchup. I could have won that. If I would have had Log, I would have won it most likely. But I think it looks better than it is right now. It is, honestly. I think this is a hard counter. And I think this is a counter as well. So I think it was, like, kind of we both won our matchups we had to win. I think this is, like, the... I think these two matchups are, like, kind of... We both can win the matchups. So I think it was overall a really great game. Let me know in the comment section which pool guys want to see next. I'm really happy with my level right now. Even we lost here. I think I'm overall improving a lot. And I'm ready for CL. And I'm excited to see which pool you guys want to see next. I'm going to be out. Peace out, guys.